All right, hi everybody. I am here with a demonstration on how to use distress markers to watercolor this cute image from Tailored Expressions from the Cool Crowd stamp set. I have stamped this image on choice watercolor paper using Versamark ink and Ranger black embossing powder, heat embossed it, and now it's ready to watercolor. I'm gonna start with tumbled glass distress ink, or distress marker, and I'm going to begin giving the snowman a little bit of a contoured edge to make him look a little bit rounded. I'm also gonna be using a plain water brush, just filled with regular water, to activate the ink and paint with it. So this is the water brush that I have. It's not any particular brand. I don't even know where I bought it from, probably Michael's. But this is what I'm gonna be using. It has a little bit of a finer point or finer tip to it. And I just like that. You don't have to use this kind, but that's the kind that I prefer. So, all right, I'm gonna start here. And I like to have my light source going, coming from the upper left. So the shadow on my snowman is going to be on the lower right. So you can see here, I'm just kind of lightly going through and putting a little bit of shadow on that side of the snowman. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually put a drop of water on my hand. I usually squeeze my paintbrush so that I have a drop of water on my hand. I don't know if you can see that. And I'm gonna go back to that anytime I need to clean my paintbrush off or get more water, I'm gonna go back to that. So then now I'm gonna take my paintbrush and I'm gonna activate this ink. And in between, I've got that activated. Now I'm gonna go kind of clean my paintbrush off and go back and spread this out. And the reason I cleaned it off and went back and did a little more is because that helps the water bleed so that, or that helps the ink bleed more evenly, okay? So now I'm gonna continue doing that on the other snowman. Whoa, my marker came apart. Okay, down here around the bottom, I tend to have a rather sketchy marker style when I use these markers. I'm gonna put a little bit up underneath his scarf, and I wish I would have done that on the first one. I'll probably go back and do that here in just a minute. All right, and now I'm gonna go back to my water brush, and I'm gonna start feathering that out, and I'm just using little zigzag strokes right now to activate that and kind of blur it. And then I'm gonna clean my brush off on my hand and go back and smooth that out the rest of the way, okay? So my water ran off of my hand, you can see, but I'll just paint on top of my hand frequently. So next, let me see if I can. I'm going to finish up this one. So I'm gonna go around the edges here, kind of lightly. If you want them to be a little bit less, if you don't want them to be quite as blue, you can use just a little bit less ink. I'm gonna continue, same process. Zigzag, kind of slightly zigzag, slightly swirly motion. If you're familiar with Copics, you do this. Here I am brushing off on my hand again, going back and smoothing this out. You could keep a paper towel handy. I don't like to dry the brush though, which is what a paper towel would do. I just kind of want to clean it off, so that's why I use my hand. All right, now the bodies are pretty much, they're set for now. I gotta let them dry a little bit. Excuse me. So now I'm done with their bodies. I need to let those dry because I have a little bit more work to do on them. But for right now, the bodies are done for what I'm going to do. I'm pretty much done with this marker for right now too. So I'm going to put it up and I'm going to get out my barn door and I'm going to start working on some scarves and hats. When I use the barn door, it's okay to move into areas that are next to things that are already wet, because normally I would say not if you hadn't embossed, you would want to let this dry completely and then come back to it. But since I embossed, I can go into other areas and they won't bleed into each other because the embossing kind of acts like a wall between the different colors of watercolor. And it also helps highlight the image. I really like the way the embossing looks, so I'm just kind of keeping with it. Now, my light source is from the top left, so I'm going to start on the lower right of this scarf. And I'm going to go in and you can see how I made my line there. And I'm going to do the same thing on the tails, like that. And I'm going to go back to my water brush, make sure it's cleaned off on my hand, and start activating that ink. Now, sometimes some colors bleed out more than others do, and that's fine. Going back here, kind of swirling a little bit, try to move that ink around. I'm going to go back to my hand, wipe off, and then pull this up. Okay, same thing here. Swirl it. Go back to my hand. Okay, and you can see I'm starting to get red ink on my hand. That's fine. Okay, so now I'm going to let that dry. I'm going to go up to his hat, and this part of his hat's going to be, so that's kind of rounded. So this part down here is going to be the dark part, and I'm going to work out towards the light. So I'm going to wet this, go back to my hand, finish dragging this out, go back to my hand again, and finish that up. Okay? Excuse me. Now I'm going to grab some green because I want my next snowman to have a little bit of green. The greens in these distress marker sets, there's not like a great medium range just green. There's a blue green, there's a great blue green, and there's a lot of kind of vintage greens, but there's not a middle ground green that I really love, so I kind of combine them. I'm going to start with pine needles, and this is the blue green. So I'm going to place the ink on the hat, same placing as I did on the red hat, and go about the same thing, stretch this out, go back to my hand and kind of dry it off or clean it off until it's faded out. Now I'm going to let that dry and then I'm going to come back to it later with my peeled paint, which is a little bit more of a yellowish vintage green, and it'll help pull that into the more average green category. So now on his scarf, I'm going to keep using my pine needles. And this is a little harder because these spaces are smaller, but you can still see I'm staying to the lower right with most of this. Doing an alternating pattern. And now I'm going to go in and do the same technique I've been doing. On some of these smaller spaces, sometimes I just get it wet because it's difficult to do any kind of shading. But if it's big enough, I do the same shading technique that I've been doing on everything else. Okay, and there's that part's done. I'm gonna go grab my red now and fill in the red sections of this. And again, beauty of the embossing is that now I can go do the red. If I hadn't embossed, I'd have to let that set and dry. So I'm painting this in, same technique. There we go. Let that dry. Now I'm going to move on to my other snowman. He's going to have a black hat, and when I start with black, I actually like to start with pumice stone first and then go to black soot. Black soot is a really strong ink and it spreads, but it stays black. It doesn't gray out very well. So I'm going to start with pumice stone, which is a nice gray, and that'll help give me a wider range of tones in the black. So same placing on my values here. I'm going to do just like that. And going to continue with the same technique of just cleaning off my brush on my hand and let that dry. I'm not done with that, but I need to let it dry for right now. This guy's gonna have a green scarf because on my other side I have my red scarf, so I'm gonna do a green scarf. I'm gonna start with my pine needles. Okay, now this one will have a little bit more value. Should be a little bit more in shadow because it's all the way on the end and our light source is on the upper left side. So if you're a stickler for a light source, you want there to be a little bit more contrast in this snowman because he's further to the side. Okay, so there we go. I'm going to let that dry. Excuse me. All right, now I've got the base colors down. It's time to go back in with a little bit more detail to help kind of iron these out a little bit. I am going to put the black buttons on the snowman. And for these, since they're so small, I'm just going to start with black set. And it'll fill in nicely. Okay. Now, to give the snowman a little bit more definition, I'm gonna go in and create some shadows with Dusty Concord. And what I usually do with this is I just take, and out of the way, I draw a little bit with the purple marker, like you can see I did up there at the top. And then I go to that with my paintbrush and pick up some purple ink. And then just in the places where I want there to be a little more contrast or shadow, I put a little purple, and then I wipe it off on my hand and blend it out so that it adds just a little bit of shadow. And you can see that this is an excellent way to quickly add just a little more depth to your image. And purple is perfect for adding more depth to an image because it goes with everything. It seems like you should want to use gray, and I understand why people would think that, but the problem with gray is that it overpowers and it doesn't fit in with a colorful image as well as purple does. Purple just works with everything. So I would highly suggest using purple to help build some shadows in your pictures. On this snowman, I need to add a little shadow here because he's behind this guy and our light's coming this way. So I need to add a little shadow right there. So I'm actually going to take my tumbled glass again and go back in and add more shadow there because I missed it the first time. So, same fading technique that I always use, cleaning off on my hand. I've got quite a little bit of ink. There we go. Okay, so now we have nice definition. I need to handle the part on the top of his hat. I'm gonna use a little red to do that. And I forgot to do my Dusty Concord in here, or my peeled pine needles in here. Excuse me. Now I'm going to take my peeled paint and go back to my greens a little bit and kind of make them a little more traditional green. So I'm going in over the same areas I did before, just pulling out a little more paint, kind of giving it, just gives it more depth. It's not so much that it changes the color a ton, it just gives it more, it's just not flat. Makes it have more depth. So same thing with this green. I don't worry about going outside the lines too much with watercolor because, in my opinion, that's what watercolor does. It's a loose medium. It's not, I don't feel like it's meant to be a super controlled medium. So if it goes outside the lines a little bit, great. Okay, so now I need to take my pumice stone and I'm gonna add a little tiny bit of fluffy definition to the fluff on this. If I hadn't heat embossed it, I would probably pull out some liquid applique and put that on there, but can't do that now that I've already heat embossed because that'll mess up the embossing. Oops, sorry, pulled that down too far. Okay, so now there's my image so far. Sorry, I keep forgetting to pull it down. Now I need to add a little shadow underneath them. I'm gonna start with my tumbled glass and I'm gonna turn this because I'm lefty. And I'm going to add some shadow on the ground, just like that. And I just kind of go back and forth with this. Kind of pull it out, pull the ink out, just like that. Okay, and that gives a nice little shadow on the ground. You can see. I'll probably go back in with a little either Dusty Concord or Pumice Stone just underneath the snowman and give them a little bit more shadow underneath. Now I'm also going to take my tumbled glass and go just in a few spots around the outside of the image, kind of just cool it down just so that it has kind of a wintry feel to it. So just a few spots, not everywhere. I don't want it to be outlined. I just want it to have a little bit of atmosphere, a tiny, tiny bit. I keep going back to my hand anytime I feel like I'm pulling too much paint around and I want it to fade out. I just wipe my brush off on my hand. Okay, so there's a little bit of atmosphere, and now I'm gonna go in with just a little bit of pumice stone. I'm gonna draw that up there at the top. You can see and pick some of that up because I'm afraid this paper is a little wet down here, so I don't want to mess that up. So I'm just going to kind of go over it just a little. And I think it's done. Here's a quick look at what my hand looks like now. You can see I kept going back to it and cleaning off my brush. But now this is dry, let it ready to dry and ready to die cut and use on a die cut and use on a project. If you decide to die cut these, be careful that your embossing doesn't go outside the die, because if it does, the embossing will crack and come off. And since I used clear Versamark, there's nothing underneath it to still show. If you used a black embossable ink, then you'd be okay. But I didn't, so it cracks off sometimes. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope helps you kind of understand distress markers a little bit more. I will be back again another time with more distress marker tutorials. I hope you like it. Thanks.